Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
Hi, this is Ilanomics and I'm joined by Ila Patnaik, an IPFP professor. Ila, talking about growth, what really are the main drivers of growth?
See, in any economy, the main drivers of growth would be like consumption growth,
right.
Exports or investment. And investment can be government investment or private investment,
right.
Particularly private corporate investment, because even within private investment, you can think about household investment and smaller companies, or it is private corporate investment, which is the big sector which drives investment growth.
Now, when we talk about investments, I mean, if we look at the investment trends, it's not very encouraging. Investments have remained very, very subdued in the last few years. What are the main reasons for this?
See, first let's go back to what the trends have been in the past and how they have changed. So, one, we've seen that investment has been the main driver of growth in the Indian economy.
Right.
The private corporate investment has swung from about 11% to 16% in the early 2000s, which is when you really saw a very sharp increase in GDP growth, because private corporate investment led that high growth of the economy, high growth of investment, and everything that went along with it, pushing the economy onto a very, very high growth path. Now, after that, after the global financial crisis, it has actually been quite subdued. So, if you look at the data for investment,
right.
From around 2011-12 or so, we find that the data shows a decline in various ways of measuring investment, other than government investment. Mm-hmm. So, government investment has continuously increased, and this is last 15 years data, so it's not about a UPA or an NDA or
right.
any particular government, but that has increased. And what you find has been really worrisome is private corporate investment, and that happened not just now, but it happened a bit after the crisis, so we were not hit by the global financial crisis.
But it's been quite some time, and we've seen the government taking quite a few steps to encourage private investments. Despite that, it hasn't really picked up. Any particular reason for that?
See, if you look at the trends, then the way it seems to have happened is that between 2004 to about 2008, there was very, very high growth of private investment. Maybe it was too high. So we track data from CMI on all projects which are announced and projects that are under implementation. So in that period leading up to the GFC, there was a lot of liquidity. Credit growth was above 30%, and that is really what was driving it. Perhaps there was too much optimism. So that was one thing that would expect would see a self-correction,
right.
and that it would come down. So it's not that one is saying that it's something bad necessarily that happened. So that's one, that it may not have been that those levels of investment could be sustained because maybe they were too much. Now, the second thing that happened was, of course, after 2008, when the global economy started slowing down, we did manage to keep investment projects going and to
right.
complete them till about 2011-12. So 3-4 years we managed to keep it going. You know, there were, at that time, you would remember
yeah.
there were tax cuts. Absolutely. And monetary policy was eased, and there was a whole policy environment
right.
To try and complete stalled projects and push that through. But then after about 11 or 12, you know, that could no longer be sustained. And from then onwards, we've been actually seeing in private investment come down, both announced and projects under implementation have both come down. About your question on what the government has been doing. So we see a blip about 14, 15.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, there seemed to have been an increase in confidence, and some additional projects were put in place. But again, that also was only for a short time. Right. And after that, I think the environment as a whole mm-hmm. has not been supportive of an increase in corporate investment.
That's quite worrisome, actually.
Yeah, yeah. It also links up to the banking yes. crisis, because Absolutely. There is currently, you know, this twin balance sheet crisis. So companies yes. are in trouble. A lot of the investment was driven by infrastructure.
Right.
And most of the infrastructure companies got into trouble. Their loans became non-performing assets. Those companies have not been able to keep investing, and these are all the big players in the market that have gotten into trouble, and then the banks are not able to
liquidity problem and all
the banks have you know, their balance sheets have been hit because companies could not return loans, those became non-performing assets, banks had to be given additional liquidity additional equity
right.
to
So was it also this reluctance from banks to sort of lend to private companies that actually led to this decline in investments?
See, it's usually very hard to say when is it a demand problem and when is it a supply issue. It seems to be a combination of both.
Okay.
And also you must remember that the demand and supply match at an interest rate.
Absolutely.
And if that interest rate is too high, then it could well be
True.
That at that level, companies don't find investment projects profitable.
Right.
You know, their balance sheets are already weak. And if you say, okay, you can borrow at, say, 12%
yeah,
or 14%,
absolutely.
Not True. Many projects will be very viable at those rates. So this combination of the banking crisis, the infrastructure investment crisis, you know,
yes,
that
right.
We saw after about 11 or 12, along with the high interest rate regime, could perhaps be some of the factors that explain this decline.
So, Ila, when do you see this trend reversing? When do we see investments finally picking up, especially private investments picking up?
See, Mawa, that's a very difficult question to answer, because before investment picks up, projects announced have to pick up.
Right.
See, when a project is announced, after that it goes through financial closure, you get all the clearances, and time lag could be anything between 7 to 8 months to a couple of years.
Right.
It depends on the policy environment, and today we are not seeing an increase in investment,
even announcements. Right.
So till we see the increase, and then after we see that increase, if the policy environment gives clearances easily,
right.
gives fast, I mean, I don't mean that laws should be violated, but you
right.
know, that how smooth is the process, how fast is that process? It also depends on financial closure. So how
right.
fast are they able to raise money?
Right.
And all that will determine how fast project announcements turn into projects under implementation.
Right. But with interest rates sort of softening now, do you think we'll finally see a few companies coming ahead and announcing at least their intentions to invest?
I think that's only one of the factors that plays into this whole very risky decision that a company has to make.
Right.
I think that the other factors also play a very big role, because after all, you invest when you think that you're going to get returns.
Right.
And not just at that, you know, 1 or 2 or 3% difference in interest rates.
Mm.
It depends on where you think demand is going to go, on whether you think you'll be able to get the clearances and so on for
right.
the project.
Right.
So there's a lot of risk that
attached to this
yeah.
entire process of investment.
Absolutely.
Right. Right. And one last question, Ila, with elections underway, do you think that's also one of the factors sort of impacting announcements?
I think people do wait to see what sort of a government will come in, and whether it has majority or not, whether
right.
it is stable or not, because there is a lot of interaction with government. Absolutely. You know, like I said, you want to get clearances, so you do want to see. So we did see a blip after 2014. Mm. So if you look at 2015-16 data, you find that investment projects went up. So there were people who felt that yes, they could, you know, go ahead and invest. So yes, right. I, you know, let's all wait and see what happens.
Right. So as Eli explained, investments have remained weak, and probably in the next few months, it's not going to really pick up anytime soon. We'll have to wait and watch. Thank you for watching. See you next week. Thank you, Eli.